The title of this two-part series is God's Word, the Miracle Seed. I want us to delve into detail of the parable to try to understand the insights that Jesus is trying to communicate to us through the parable. Now, you and I understand that in his teaching, the Lord Jesus used many parables. That means he spoke using earthly things to teach us about heavenly truth or heavenly realities. Jesus said it, he made it so plain. He said there in verse 14, the sower sows the word. So the first thing we must understand is that God's word is like seed. God works through his word, and his word is like seed. His word is a miracle seed. Now, this is not the only way God works, but this is a very important way, and I would say a major way, a very important way by which God works. It is through his word. His word is like seed. So when you have your Bible with you, this Bible is God's miracle seed that has been made available to you. That means through this seed, the very work of God can be released in you and through you into your life situation, because God works through his word. His word is like seed. So if you and I want to see God work in our lives, what we must learn to do is take the seed, put it into our hearts, and go through the process, work with God through the process, so that that seed will release its power in our lives. First truth, the first fact is this: God's word is miracle seed. Every promise in the Bible is full of potential to produce in your life. Whatever you need, whatever you want God to do in your life, it can happen by and through the miracle seed of his word. So the second thing is this: our heart is the ground where the seed of God's word is to be sown. Many of us know the word, we can recite it, we can say it, but we don't believe it. How can I know that the word hasn't stopped in my mind, but it goes into my heart? It's when I believe it. When you read the word of God, when you take the promises of the word, by his stripes I've been healed. My God shall supply all my need according to his riches in glory through Christ Jesus. When you take those promises and you believe it in your heart, then you know the word has gone into your heart. The word must be sown into your heart. Now, how do we get that word into our spirit? He tells us repeatedly, meditate in my word. Meditate in my word. As you read the word of God, what we must also learn to do is to meditate in the word. Because meditation is this process by which we take that word and let it be sown, not just in our minds, but into our spirit. Meditating in the word of God. If you want to break meditation down, how do you meditate in the word? If you break it down, you'll understand that it involves contemplation. That means focused attention on the word of God. You contemplate on the word. You visualize the word. That means you let the word engage your imagination. And you also confess the word. That means you let the word occupy your saying, your declaration, your confession, what you're saying. God's word is miracle seed. Take the seeds that promise blessing. Take the seeds that promise success. Take the seeds that promise your prosperity. Put it into your life. Put it into your heart. And that seed of the word will produce the success you need. You see, God's word will not fail. Jesus said, heaven and earth will pass away, but my words will not pass away. His word will produce in your life if you and I will nurture it the way Jesus taught us in this parable. But the first thing is this: you've got to sow the seed into your heart.